Mechanical project development starts with the designing. So first you have to design the system in a software or on paper, and after that you can start the fabrication. If you create or fabricate a system without the designing, there is no guarantee it will work as intended. So there are many softwares available to do the designing, including SolidWorks, AutoCAD, and even other softwares like FreeCAD. So whichever software you use, the GUI is different, but the process or the working remains the same. So there are 2D as well as 3D softwares available. So first you have to create the design of the system or the mechanism that you are making, and after that you can go ahead for fabrication. So whichever tool you use, you just need to create a design first, and then you can proceed to the fabrication of the system.
So now, after studying the project design part, we will now study the project parts, its fabrication and assembly of the project. So to start with, we will first need to access the project block diagram. So just search Neon Projects to access the block diagram of the project. When you reach the website, just scroll down here and then you can search the project name. And this is the project. So this is the complete setup, but first we will scroll down to the block diagram, which is a simple explanation of the system. As you can see, this is the pneumatic actuator, this is the sensor here, and this is the motor. The motor operates the belt, and accordingly we have here the pneumatic cylinder, which is, or the actuator, which is used to push the faulty products out of the line. And this is the IR sensor. And these are the rollers attached to the motor, which move the belt, which is used for moving the products over the conveyor. And as you can see, this is the base frame of the system. So now let's check a more detailed version of the system, the actual one. As you can see, this is the metal frame here, and these are the rollers fitted through bearings here, and this is the motor which is used to run the system. I'll show you the motor and the individual parts in some time. And as you can see, this is the pneumatic valve. The valve is used for switching the air supply, which leads the cylinder to make a stroke, and this is how it pushes the faulty product out of the system. And as you can see, this is the IR sensor, which is attached here. This is used to detect faulty sensors. So in this system, we consider faulty products as deformed products or short products, which are detected by the system. So based on the height, we detect which products are faulty, and the faulty products are pushed out of the line, out of the conveyor line, using the pneumatic cylinder. And this is the control circuitry, which is used to control the entire system. It detects the faulty products, and thus it operates the actuator or the cylinder to drive out the faulty products using the valve. So now let's study these parts. As you can see, the main part of the system is the pneumatic cylinder. So you can find a variety of pneumatic cylinders here, whichever is compatible you are comfortable with as per your system. If you want to customize the design, you can use any cylinder from here. After that, we have the pipes or the tube and the tubes. So these are the pipes. As you can see here, there are pipes of various thicknesses. You can, a 1 mm thickness pipe is enough for this system requirement. and along with that you need a valve. So you just need a two-way position valve for this. And to connect the valve and the pipe, you will be needing these fittings here. So depending on your pipe size and your valve size, you need to select proper fittings so that you can get a proper pipe and valve connection here. After that, we have the DC motor here. You will need get DC motors for this requirement. These are various gear DC motors, so depending on the needed RPM you can select a motor whichever is comfortable as per your requirement. And these are the pneumatic fittings and valves which I already showed you. Apart from that, the system requires rollers and bearings and the metal frame along with the sensor and the system combined together and the controlling circuitry, as you can see here. So if you don't have idea about all these components, the design and the electronics part, you can also click on order now and order all these components together in a single kit so that you can assemble it yourself and make it yourself at home with ease, and also learn about it using the provided design and the data. So now let's proceed to the testing on the working of the system.